Yo, what's your man, Mr. Ghost Saints? I'm coming back at you with another Ghost Saints video, man. Look, I got this shit loaded up. And we about to try to get us another dub, man. That's why we here. I think that's why we all here. To get us a dub. But hey, man. If you think you got it, bro. If you think you got it like that. You not one of them OP team runners. And you run with your squad, bro. Let's run it up. Let's run it up.
Got yourself tuned into the right station.
Let's see what we can make happen around this bit.
Throwing first play is Pickett. Now a short pass pulled in by Washington. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. The big play to start him out has him at the 45 already. Johnson's got it complete. The result, only 4 yards there on the play. And it's second down. Back to throw, Pickett. His throw incomplete. That pass just a little bit off. It looked like maybe he tried to force it in there.
Game speed, always different, no matter what you do in practice. Can't simulate it, right? So your decision making, everything has to be a little bit quicker. Sometimes it can throw you off until you adjust.
So after the second down incompletion, they'll come up now against a 3rd and 6. Dialing up another pass here, Pickett. And that is incomplete.
One first down here, and that's all, folks. Good work by this defense to hold things in check and force a punting situation.
On 4th down, here's Presley Harvin on to punt. And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchdown.
Oh, that's blitz over there. What's that in blitz? You ain't saying nothing, big dog. Shit, you ain't saying shit, but I can't hear you. What's happening over there? I cannot hear you. Man, what's up with this voice chat? Hold up, blitz. See what's up with this voice chat. I can't hear you, blitz. I got voice chat on. got it on, big dog, but I can't hear you. That's unfortunate. I don't know what's going on with that. Because I see your speaker moving. And obviously you can hear me because you said something when I said something, but I can't hear you. I don't know what the hell going on with this right here.
Carr going to lead the Saints up here first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
Really, blitz coming at me in a couple full blitz.
Come out throwing here to start the drive. There's a short one to the tight end Johnson, and he'll go down at the 26, following a gain of 6. That's a staple of this offense, drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
From the 26, they'll line up on 2nd and 4. Here's Carr. He'll get this one underneath to Kamara. And Kamara's going to have a Saints first down as he'll get this up across the 30-yard line. Throwing now is Carr. Incomplete.
That certainly appeared to be a play call where they were just trying to make 2nd down, 2nd and short. I think they thought the coverage was off a little bit more than it was. Nice job there pressing up on it and forcing the incompletion.
Carr again here on 2nd and 10. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
Throwing his car on 3rd down. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. A pair of 1st downs gives him a 1st and 10 up at the 44. They'll run it for the first time with Alvin Kamara. And a strong run that time as he's across midfield and down to the 43. Carr now on 1st down. And this one almost intercepted. Not a good throw there.
I don't know when they're going to stop or when they're going to fucking keep going. Maybe stopping some of them routes before they're supposed to be stopping some of them routes.
Exhale just a little bit there with incompletion on 1st down. Now they have to gear up, try and get 2 more stops and escape this drive.
Another throw on 2nd down, and this one incomplete as well. So he's 3 for 7 throwing the football right now. Not an awful start, but also not the sharpest of starts.
No, I would agree with that. But if you're a confident quarterback and to play that position, you have to be. You just act like there's something wrong with the wind currents or something wrong with the ball. It is not you. Keep throwing. That timing usually develops.
From the gun now on 3rd down, Carr. And he's going to be sacked. They sack him back right at the midfield strike.
Bro, what the fuck is this?
No move to pull Carr and the offense off. They're going to go on 4th down. Now on 4th down, we've got a whistle here and a timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. And how about this? 4th and long, and they're going to go for it. From midfield, here's Carr.
Bruh.
Rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Levi Wallace with a pick. And he'll take this all the way down inside the
I'm trying to come back for the ball. Oh boy, dove for it. Oh, man.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. Pickett sets up play action. He sets to fire deep. Oh, he had a man running free, but he overshot him, and it's incomplete.
Looked like they were set up defensively in a zone coverage, but somehow they found a seam because that receiver, all alone, by rights, that should have been a touchdown, but somehow this ball's overthrown.
Pickett back to the air on second down. But he's got his target, Harris. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Now some movement before the snap. And we'll hear from our referee for the first time this afternoon. The full start backs him up 5, first and 15. Pickett gonna move his guys around. He'll look to throw.
There we go, Tyron.
Intercepted. Picked off by the Honey Badger. They're gonna take over once again, and they'll have it at their own 8-yard line. So consecutive interceptions here early on in this one, and maybe setting the tone, Charles, for a game where the defense really takes center stage.
And don't you think that both offenses are really catching a bit from their coaching staff about avoiding these turnovers that we've seen early?
Come on, Foster Moreau, bro. You got to catch that block right there.
Can one of them break away and take control of this game?
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. Again, it's Kamara. And they get him behind the line, so that should be on first down, quickly negated. We're scoreless after one.
Really, my God?
They'll come to the line here needing 9 yards to pick up the first. On third down, here's Kamara. And brought down, but not before they're able to get it up to the 25. So after the run by Kamara, now another first and 10. One back in the backfield, he'll get the carry. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10. On second down, here's Carr. He throws and he hits the slant route to Thomas. And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here up to the 34. The offense on third down, they've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. They need just a yard here. It's 3rd and 1. Here's Kamara trying to run for it. And this will wind up a Saints first down as the tackle made it about the 43-yard line.
Yeah, once more, strong running, excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
A couple of first downs has the football positioned at the 43 as they come up first and 10. Tries the left side and finds Olave. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. Just need a yard here, 2nd and 1. They'll run out of the gun with Kamara. And they'll get this just to the 47, 1 yard gain. So offensively on this drive, 2 of 2 on third downs, and now they face a 3rd and inches. Now Carr. They'll get this out to Kamara. And he is going to have a Saints first down as he's able to get about 3 that time on 3rd and inches. Second quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game.
Gotta say, I was a little surprised to see him, Charles, come out in the shotgun on third and less than a yard.
Yeah, but the way the NFL is nowadays, we hardly ever see anyone really run for it on short yardage. So they're gonna throw the football more times than not. That was a nice, easy rhythm throw right there, and they pick up the first down.
They'll give him 4 yards there, and it'll be second down.
That's now four completions in a row. A good bounce back following the interception last drive.
Certainly not letting it affect him, that's for sure. And we all know interceptions are going to happen. So the big trick, don't let it affect you going forward. Most of the good quarterbacks, they just tell the ball boy, get down and out of the rotation, give me a fresh ball, and let's go. He's got his offense moving again.
Into the red zone, it's Carr. Well, he tried to fit it in on the slant, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Minka Fitzpatrick. And the Steelers are going to take over at their own 13-yard line. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive as they take over with exactly 1 minute to go here before intermission. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Finds Pickens out right. And out of bounds across the 15-yard line. And just 3 yards on the catch there. He couldn't get away. And that will bring up second down. Now Pickett looking to change things up. Here's a second and 7. Got his man, it's Warren. Now the Steelers use the first of their 3 timeouts as the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number 1. A yard all they need, but it's third down. Now they'll change things around before the snap. Pickett on third and 1.
Bruh! You fucking right there, bro. Fucking missed that play. Good job. Good job, Pete.
There on third and a yard. To the air on first down with Pickett. Throw left side complete. Now the Steelers use the second of their 3 timeouts.
Good job.
Catch for him there on this drive, Brandon, and it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
Meanwhile, Pickett's throw into the hands of Pickens, and he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. Another strong gain on the last 2 plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards.
And partner, they're locked in man coverage out left, and they end up running a crossing route. Rounded it a little bit more than a slant. He's just going to angle himself towards the right side of the field, and that's very difficult for a defender to shadow him across all that ground.
Pickett now on first down. And that is incomplete. Now the coverage a little too good there. And it's second down.
This team is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
Second and 10. It's Pickett again. He'll get this complete to Calvin Austin. Now the Steelers going to use their 3rd and final timeout as they'll stop it with 14 seconds to go in this first half.
But that's what you're looking for when you're wanting to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. Spotted at the left hash, this from 45. Boswell's kick is good, and we have action on the scoreboard just before halftime. It's 3-0. So the defense able to force the interception, and the offense working their way into field goal range and able to get three out of it.
Yeah, and give them credit for that. They took the ball, maneuvered it downfield, and while they could
look it up into the roof, and he muffs it. It's loose. And they'll be set up with good field position here as he gets this up over the 40-yard line.
At some point, we're going to get it through our heads. Special teams, special teams, special teams. The spark that often wins games.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And maybe a chance for a quick completion and then a long field goal try. We'll see. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
As his old brain remembers, when I see five wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out high. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
The final shot here before half for Carr. He's going to try and go deep again. And that is incomplete. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. We welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. Just one field goal in a tightly played first half as we resume action here in quarter number three. From his end zone, here's Rashid Shaheed. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So something has to change here in quarter three.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well. They've kept them around in this game. Now they've got some time. The running game struggled in the first half. Opposition knows how to focus on defending the pass here. They've got to re-energize that ground game and maybe open things up for a comeback here in this half. Oh, partner, just a second earlier, and they might have had him, because they certainly thought they were going to close in and drop him behind the line of scrimmage, but he had just enough time to dodge the pressure, and he ends up getting yardage before being stopped.
Now Carr. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
And so many times we look at the opening drive of the third quarter as a tone setter, and many coaches do emphasize it, and that's a strong performance there defensively to force incompletion and, more importantly, force a quick punting situation.
They failed once in this spot earlier, but the offense will stay out to go for it on fourth down. They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And the Steelers, they're going to take over an excellent field position. Now a first down carry for Harris. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two. He gets it left side to Johnson. And in for the Steelers.
Look at that fucking shit.
Kenny Pickett connecting with Deontay Johnson. And the Steelers are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Extra point put through by Boswell.
And look at this shit right here.
Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. Right after the touchdown to extend their lead, now maybe opening the door a little bit there by allowing starting field position at the 40. Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at the 41-yard line. Play action, now it's Carr. That is hauled in by Michael Thomas. Now he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Throwing on first down, it's Carr. Touchdown, Saints.
Bro, that shit got my whole fucking kick meter blocked. That's crazy.
And they're going to mark that where it went out of bounds. So really good starting field position up past the 40-yard line.
Bro. Got the whole fucking meter blocked.
Pickett leads the Steelers up here with a fresh set of downs at the 41-yard line. They'll set up to throw. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Part of what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
Now Pickett changing the play. And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. It's brought in by Harris. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Now they'll audible to something else. Off play action, Pickett.
Ooh.
Washington's got it. Washington, 47 yards, and they are able to add on to their advantage. Boswell the extra point, and his guys will take a 10-point lead. Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. And solid field position here to start as they get this out to the 40-yard line.
It's the third quarter, and they're down on the scoreboard. And while no one wants to hit the panic button just yet, points are a necessity on this drive. What a great way to get set up.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. A strong showing their last time out. They scored the touchdown, but Charles, they look up, and they're still down double digits, so you feel like just to keep pace, this drive probably needs to end in the end zone as well.
Yeah, and I think the best move for them is to not worry about how far they are down on the scoreboard, but to just remember the last drive and how it ended. Go ahead and try and repeat that. Then you can look at the scoreboard and see where this game is.
Maybe a little frustration starting to creep in. The offensive line hasn't done a great job of protecting him in this game, and there he was, hit again as he threw it.
Yeah, another time on his backside. Probably starting to get a little frustrated.
Oh, motherfucker.
Can't let the defense know that they're getting to him.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. On play action, now Carr. He's got his target. That's complete. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. A good pickup there, 26 yards. Operating out of Steeler territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 35-yard line. Now a play fake. Carr. He finds his man, Johnson. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. Fake the handoff. Now Carr. Flush to his right. And he's got it. It's caught.
Into the middle of the field on a scramble. He did it and got away with it for a touchdown.
Instinct sometimes, right? They just take over.
Instinct and vision. Sometimes you just see people who are open, you're able to get it to them.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away.
That motherfucker got that set right in front of my fucking kick meter, bro. Oh, come on. That's supposed to be a kill set.
At the line to start their next drive. Still enjoying the lead here in the third quarter despite their defense giving up that last touchdown. Now they'll see if they can get the equalizer here on this drive. And he'll fight forward on the straight ahead running for just a couple of yards. Second down. Tackle is made by Cameron Jordan. As they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching me. Got it here at the 29 on second and 8. Pickett. Short pass pulled in by Washington and past the 40 before he's out of bounds. That one good for 14 yards and a Steeler first.
Well, that should be a reminder defensively, and I think it's a reminder to myself because you just can't sell out to stop the run. There's still enough time that this offense can move the football through the air, even on first and second downs, and they obviously picked the right spot to throw the ball there.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
So many offenses want to include their running backs into their passing offense and be able to swing the ball out and check it down to them. But sometimes those guys are just not as comfortable catching the ball as they are running it.
Pickett going to move his guys around.
Bro, get the fuck out of here, bro.
Short pass pulled in by Washington, and he will have a Steelers first down as
fucking really, bro.
There on third sets up play action. And too much juice. It'll be out of bounds, incomplete.
Offense was moving it a little bit, had them back on their heels, but they earned a brief pause by forcing the incompletion. That gives them a quick chance to regroup and try and mount a stand before they're backed up even further.
Here's second and 10. Now they'll change things up. Pickett back to the air on second down.
There we go.
Look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted.
All day made. All day made.
For a loss of 12, and it also brings up fourth down. Here comes the Saints punter now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away.
Bro, what the
line drive almost whiffed on it. Now Austin.
Bro, they fucking over us with that fucking kick meter, bro.
Set of downs right at the 50-yard line. Harris will start to drive out, and just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. Decent start defensively to this series. They've got to stop them here and get this ball back.
I like the way you phrase that, partner. Decent start, but now it's got to be more about the ball. It's all about the ball, getting it away from them, because making good tackles is one thing, but a clock will run out on you. You've got to have the football back for your offense.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. That's swung out.
Man, get the fuck out of here, bro.
Second timeout. But you can also factor in another timeout that they'll get when the clock stops at the 2-minute warning. This is second and 8. Here's Pickett. They'll get this to his tight end. That's Pat Freiermuth. 2 minutes remain, and that's our score differential as well. 2 points here in the fourth quarter.
Bruh.
Running straight ahead.
No, this fucking man stopped, bro. Bro, come on, you right there, pick the fucking ball.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
This is certainly a team that has proven it likes to target its backs through the air, and defensively, they were aware of that and certainly were prepared on that throw.
Second and 10. That one looks like he'll throw here. Kenny Pickett fighting Pat Freiermuth, and the Steelers are able to build on to their fourth quarter.
Man, that's horrible right there.
Important extra point up and through, and it might seal the deal as that makes it a two-score game here with not a lot of time remaining. Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. Come up first and 10 here. Carr to throw.
What?
Give it big credit for his coverage right there, because when he saw the route break deep, he stayed.
And I already decided to give it to him. They didn't already call a game, man. When you dudes drop wide open passes like that, bro, they didn't already call a game on you, dog. They didn't already call game on. Bro, what's up with this fucking voice tag, though?
It's the NFL on EA Sports, and we are at Venerable Soldier Field in Chicago. Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one, as it'll be the New Orleans Saints taking on the Chicago Bears. Set for football, and off we go from Soldier Field. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18.
All right, what the fuck is this? Bro, what? Now I can't hit no buttons. Yeah, bro, this shit fucking tripping, bro. That shit started tripping right quick. First with the fucking kick meter. Yeah, man, that kick meter was bonkers. Here we go. Yeah, man, that kick meter was absolutely bonkers just now.
You've got yourself tuned into the right station. I thought they was about to let me take that shit. Fucking Madden, boy.
The Dolphin passing game rolling here. They've got another first down. Here's Tagovailoa to throw. And he's going to go down. Sacked right around the 17. It'll be a loss of five there as the safety blitz winds up paying off. And it's never good to take a sack. You really don't want to take one down here in this part of the field down near the red zone.
Not at all, because you're already pretty much assured of a field goal. But you take a big sack, it could push you out of range, and that's why defenses get a little more aggressive in this situation. They're almost conceding the 3 points. They want to push you back and try to take you out of that.
And he'll get 7 yards from the 17 to the 10 before he's taken down. It's been a pretty long opening drive. This will be play number 11 coming up on third down. And that is caught. Touchdown, Miami. Tyreek Hill on the touchdown pass from Tua. And the Dolphins get the upper hand as they're on the board first here this afternoon. Extra point up and good by Sanders, and it's now a 7-0 game. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders.
Be drawing Ironside.
This taken in at the goal line. And they'll be backed up to
they really ain't do this dude justice with the ratings.
Carr gonna lead the Saints up here first and 10 at their own 15. They begin on the ground with Kamara, and he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up. Second down and 8. Carr now to throw. Here's a short one to the tight end, Johnson. And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. To his running back, it's Alvin Kamara. Well, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. 28 yards the gain there on the catch and run. So now first and 10 as they've crossed into Miami territory at the 38. Against this complete to Shaheed. He'll be hit down at the 33, 5 yards on the play. Here's Carr to throw. Looking long for Thomas.
Oh, come on, Colts.
He overshot him. It's incomplete.
That was a chance for the breakthrough. He's got a man running free, and you've got to be able to put that on him. But instead, led him too far, incomplete.
That'll be taken in by Shaheed. Get this down near the 20-yard line. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down.
That's the third time on this drive that these two have connected with each other. They've got a real rapport going. And right now, it's paying off with big chunks of yardage, as shown by that last play.
Again, it's Carr.
Oh, you motherfucker. Why they be fucking over my squad, dog?
Another ideas, and they're trying to mount a small stand before this drive reaches the end zone.
Carr, a quick throw, it's complete. 5 yards now.
Give me them horrible ass animations.
5 on this play to move the sticks.
Can't triple step a double stamp.
just shy of the 10 at the 11 or the 12.
Plenty of things to talk about here, partner, but to me, their defense gave up a touchdown on the first drive. How about how they're responding, coming back? That's a big third down pickup to keep their drive alive.
Now a first down carry. It's Kamara. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Jerome Baker crashing downhill and getting the stop. They run it again with Kamara. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. From the gun, it's Carr. Flushed out right. And probably the wise decision there. No one open. He just throws it away. And that keeps the field goal on the table as it's fourth down.
Well, how about the coverage we just saw break out on third down? Dime defense blanketed the field with extra defensive backs and speed. Unable to find an open hole to complete that pass.
It's up and good, and we're tied at 7 here in quarter number 2. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And they'll be set up pretty nicely here as they have it up to the 35-yard line. First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. Tie ball game, still a little more than a minute to go in the half. The question, can they put something together here, try to take that lead into intermission?
I would have to think that would be the goal for sure. I don't think you sit on anything here. Here's your opportunity. Push it downfield. As you mentioned, it's a tie game. So minus a disaster on your part, you've got that in your back pocket. Go ahead and try and get some points and feel great going into the half.
Tagovailoa to throw on second down here. And the Saints pressure gets him. Brought down for a sack. Two are going to try and go quickly here. Throwing is Tagovailoa on third down here. He's got his target. That's complete. Now the Dolphins going to burn the
first fucking bullshit.
As they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Setting to throw on first.
Oh! Oh, he gave that shit up on purpose! Man, I ain't never seen no fucking bullshit like that, bro. A fucking man had the fucking pick and let him catch that shit, bro. Man, this fucking game. Fucking man right there to take the fucking pick, bro, and let him catch it. Right there to take the pick. Pulled his fucking arms back. Come on, bro. Come on, bro.
After the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders.
Bro, I'd be having to jump through fucking hoops to win fucking games just because people get these fucking garbage ass teams that's doing well right now.
Set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. with this slim deficit closing in on the end of the first half. We'll see if they can move this at least into field goal range and try to get three out of this drive. And he'll work this back to right around the line of scrimmage and surrender there. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Now Carr. Here's Johnson with a reception. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. The big play has them all the way out near midfield for a first and 10. To throw, it's Carr. Again, it's Johnson. They'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. And they'll burn the timeout with 5 seconds left. A chance to try to add 3 points before heading to the locker room. Now with 5 seconds left, not really enough time to run another play and then stop it. So on comes the field goal unit. On the left hash mark, this a 38-yard attempt. And his kick here is good. And they'll cut the lead back down to 4 now at 14-10. So they're able to end that drive with 3 points in this one possession ball game.
And ideally, you want to end every drive with points. Most quarterbacks would tell you, let's end it with a kick, right? A PAT, that's number one. Field goal, you'll take. Punts, you really don't want to do that. In this case, they'll take the field goal and get prepared for the rest of the game.
And we'll still have time for one play before the half, as this will be fair caught and brought out to the 25. Tua, the final shot before half. And he's going to be taken down here as that will lead us to the end of the first half of play. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL and it's on EA Sports. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. The Saints going to go on offense first, and they trail here as we begin quarter number three. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down officially at the 21. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. But Charles, we saw a pretty entertaining first half, close ball game. Remember there toward the end of the second quarter, the opposition scored to take the lead. Now we'll see if these guys can get a score of their own to regain that lead.
Yeah, they want to have that type of a response, don't they? Because they want to find a way to take control of this ball game one more time. Gauntlet's been thrown down. They want to see if they're ready to answer it.
Throwing again on second down, but this time it's incomplete.
As soon as he leaked out and began his route, someone on the defensive side broke with him and arrived just in time to separate him from another reception.
Throwing his car on third down.
Bro, what the fuck, man?
The Bears are going to come up empty on this first drive of the second half.
The computer made me drop 3 straight fucking balls, bro.
Okay, you know, when you sit and analyze it, they're not happy about what happened, having to go to the bench. But this gives them a chance to let their defense do some work while they, on the sidelines, go over what they're doing offensively and formulate a proper plan.
Carr gonna go on fourth down. Olave hauls it in. And now this is gonna be close. The defense says they stopped him.
Fucking bullshit, bro. 3 straight fucking drops right in his fucking hands. Come on, bro.
Whatsoever. Second and 10.
Absolutely love the effort there. The ability to flow from his inside spot and stop that one at the line of scrimmage. Nice linebacker play.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. Throwing now is Tagovailoa. He's got his running back out of the backfield. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Here's Mostert. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Dolphins touchdown. Raheem Mostert. Dolphins are able to add on to that lead. Sanders on for the extra point.
This fucking game is so broken, bro.
It's good, and it's 21-10.
I get this motherfucker. Three straight fucking in-hand drops. I was protecting the ball, by the way. Not only was I protecting the ball, but yeah, yeah. This is fucking retarded, bro. Tell me you're trying to give him the fucking win without telling me giving him the fucking win.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. They'll look to make some inroads here, trailing 21-10 as they come up on a 1st and 10. Carr gonna throw. Now he's free up the left sideline. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
And he'll be brought down right around the 37. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Carr now on 1st down. Blitz coming, and down he goes.
I guess he can't throw the fucking ball.
The pass rush will be equally intense here on 2nd down following the sack. It's 2nd and 18. Carr now to throw. That's complete to his running back, Kamara. And they'll wind up getting this to the 37. Gain of 9. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on 3rd down. To throw his car. I had a man open, but he missed him, and it's incomplete.
Looks like another empty possession offensively. And you're at that point in the game where you can't afford too many more of these. So this is going to require some heavy thinking on the sideline to figure out what they can do to crack this defense.
Still just a 3rd quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on 4th. It's Carr. And they hit him as he throws, as this one's going to go straight down to the turf. Incomplete. A surprising move to go for it, predictably, at least somewhat predictably. It doesn't pay off, and that will force a turnover on downs. 2 and now on 1st down. Eluding the pressure right. And Tua going to slide to a halt, but he will have the 1st down. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
The defense did its job of taking away a quick throw, but that's only half the battle because they've got to get to him before he can make a run for it. A little bit late containing him there, so he makes a nice gain out of a play that looked like it was in trouble.
Motion man is Berrios. And he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29. So their task a little bit more difficult now. 2nd and 13 that they're walking up on. Tua gonna throw.
Bro, come on, bro. Man, they really got my men stopping and giving them the fucking ball, bro. That is fucking horrible. That is fucking horrible. Like, dude, be right there. They stop right before the fucking point of attack. Come on, man. Come on, dog. Come on with the nonsense, bro. How much more fucking nonsense I gotta put up with, man? Jeez. Just because I don't play with one of them bullshit ass teams, man, that's bullshit, bro. That's bullshit. Bro, what the fuck? This the team I get next? Come on, bro. Come on, bro.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Superdome in downtown New Orleans. Today we've got a solid matchup in store in the NFC, as it'll be the Philadelphia Eagles taking on the New Orleans Saints. The kicker Jake Elliott ready to get this one started, and we are underway from the Superdome. From his end zone, here's Rashid Shaheed, and ultimately cannot get this out to the 25 yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
Bullshit number one right there.
Here's Carr. Eagle pressure, too much this time. Down he goes. Josh Sweat rushing in and bringing him down to the ground.
It always helps for a visiting team to come in and set the tone on defense. In fact, when we talked with them prior to the game,
fuck,
they said they wanted this home
that,
crowd.
Bro.
It felt like they had to hide their valuables when they were in town.
Well, the home crowd quiet now early. See if their offense can take over and get some points on the board. Now, meanwhile, they go for it on fourth down, and my goodness, incomplete. A surprising move here on the opening drive of the game, and this defense delivers a turnover on downs on the very first drive of the afternoon. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. On the option to get to Swift here. And he is in.
Man.
Philadelphia. DeAndre Swift.
That's just the bullshit I be talking about, bro. That shit makes absolutely no sense. I just had the same type of animation run. I run into the back of my man and hit the fucking ground. Oh, man.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. Charles, we know that this offense is aggressive. We saw that last drive. They went for it on fourth down, didn't get it. Then they give up the touchdown. So now you feel like they really need to respond here.
They certainly do, but let's face it. Sometimes when you take that risk, you understand if you fail, a little more onus goes back on your ball club to try and pick themselves back up.
After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20. On play action, now Carr. In trouble here.
Trying to send the fucking whole fucking blitz on my motherfucking ass.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Under pressure, they got him again.
Wow.
That sack courtesy of the effort of Hassan Reddick. And that is the third sack this offensive line has allowed this first quarter.
Yeah, that puts him on pace. Let me do the rudimentary math here. To be sacked 12 times in a game, I know he's not going to go for that. I wonder if it's going to reshape what they decide to do on offense in terms of play call.
Well, I can tell you what, when he popped up, shaking his head, frustrated right now behind center. Now on fourth,
that fucking bullshit.